To install the TEROS 21 sensor, you should have the following items. Begin by auguring or digging a trench to the desired sensor depth. Here we'll show a trench so you can see the process more easily. After the hole has reached the correct depth, measure to verify. Label the sensor with the intended depth. Place the label at the top, near the stereo plug that inserts into the logger. This will help you keep track of sensor depths. In a field notebook, record the sensor's serial number, the corresponding depth and data logger port, plus any other information about the site that may be hard to recall when analyzing the data. Cut a thin vertical pilot hole into the side of the borehole or trench with a knife or tool. Ensure the slit is slightly thinner than the sensor. Moisten the native soil until it forms a ball. Press a small amount of pre-moistened native soil into the sensor openings to ensure the soil is in contact with all the surfaces of the ceramic. Then pack more soil firmly around the sensor discs. If installing in a sandy soil that doesn't adhere to the sensor even when wet, refer to the manual. Insert the pre-packed sensor into the pilot hole with the body vertical. It should take some effort to push in the sensor. If it slips in too easily, the slit is too big and there won't be good soil to sensor contact. Some of the moistened soil should slip off as the sensor is inserted. After insertion, plug the sensor into the data logger and push the test button. Use the scan feature in the software to check for proper sensor function before backfilling. Protect near ground cables by installing in conduit or plastic cladding to prevent severed cables or disconnected sensors. At least 10 centimeters or 4 inches of cable should exit the sensor body in a straight line before bending the cable. You can bury the remainder of the protected cables or leave them above ground. Run the other end of the conduit up the data logger post for approximately 60 centimeters or 2 feet. Zip tie the conduit to the post, leaving a small amount of slack, so the cable won't be pulled out of the logger. Backfill the trench or hole with native soil. Replace the soil in reverse order of removal to avoid mixing the horizon layers. Tamp the soil in layers with PVC or a tamping tool, carefully repacking to a soil density similar to the surrounding undisturbed soil. Be careful not to dislodge the sensor. At the top of the borehole, mound the soil slightly to allow for soil settling. Replug the sensor into the data logger. Use data logger software to apply appropriate settings to the sensors plugged into each data logger port. Close the lid of the data logger over your labels for protection from the weather. The TEROS 21 is now ready to measure water potential.